achieve efficient data delivery in mobile social networks. So, okay. Again, my lab, the other lab, this is the logo of my lab, and we design by ourselves, and we have a website, the otherlab.org. You can find some information about the research, about the people, about the publications, research of our lab. We are interested in several topics, as I have introduced yesterday. I introduced some of our work in computational social science and the big data yesterday, and today I am going to introduce some of our recent work on this area, mobile social networks, especially on socially aware networking. Here's the agenda of this talk, and first I will begin with a brief introduction of socially aware networking. What socially aware networking? And then I will introduce our work on three topics. The first one is socially aware routing and forwarding. Then followed by how to deal with node selfishness in routing and forwarding. And then finally, I will talk about socially aware congestion control. So anyway, what's socially aware networking? If you are interested, you can read this paper, this survey paper. It was published in IEEE Systems Journal 2015. The title is Socially Aware Networking and a Survey. We wrote this paper in actually 2013. Around 2013, early 2013, we already finished the paper, but it's published 2 years ago due to the long delay peer review process. Of course, it's accepted, actually accepted 3 years ago already. So the reference might be a bit out of date. Sorry about that. Why we need socially aware networking? There are quite a lot of motivations, actually. As we all know, the mobile devices have become very popular. There are many different types of mobile devices, including mobile phones, of course, right? And also our cars. So when you move with your mobile phones move with you. So your trajectory is also the trajectory of your mobile phones. So mobile devices and ourselves are integrated. So also car. When you drive your car goes and then you go. So you and your car have the same GPS. So that makes integration of cyber-physical aspects. Cyber-physical aspects, for example, car and our mobile phones, and ourselves, social, human beings. So there is a trend of that these mobile devices will be connected wirelessly. So we have connected cars and also we have connected mobile phones. And of course we can find many, many other types of mobile devices. So that's the trend we can observe, which leads to mobile social networks. So there are many challenges there. Resource. Many mobile devices has very limited resources, and also there are complexity. due to, for example, the mobility. Mobility of cars, mobility of human beings, mobility of mobile devices. And then, mobility leads to change of topology.